Hi there, my name is Corneel de Toey and I would like to tell you a little bit more about my Jessam Clear Cut Stock Eyes, my DIY version. If you haven't seen the commercial one, I'll post a link down below and you can have a look and see what the commercial one is looking like. So basically, the Jessam Clear Cut Stock Eyes has got three functions. First function is to provide downward pressure on your board as you put it through the table saw. Second one is to provide sideways pressure to pull it into the fence as you do the cut. And the third one is to prevent kickback, should kickback want to happen. So basically, to start off with, I made two mounting blocks. Basically, an off-cut piece of wood, about 35 by 45 by about 95 millimeters long. First thing to do was to drill a hole through the center of the block at a slight angle, and to get the angle I just use a off-cut piece of MDF to lift the block on the one side. Then I cut the slot through the front so that I can pinch it down. Two 8mm holes for some 8mm bolts. This bolt then gets mounted on the top of my table saw, and the blocks basically get mounted on top of that. To keep them down, I just made these DIY star knobs. To keep them down. Cool, and as you can see, already mounted the second one. Then, to provide the downward pressure, this is basically what the rod and the arm and the wheel looks like. The rod obviously is 25mm to go through the hole. And then at the front you will see I've glued in three thin strips of hardwood. In this case it's African rosewood. And then just made a mounting block with a 6mm hole and just a inline skate wheels that I bought at my local sports shop. And then obviously one for the second mounting block as well. And then to set the height of these clear cut stock lights, basically just drop them down. As you can see, there's a gap of about 10mm over there. Drop them down, tighten the knobs nice and tight, make sure it doesn't twist. Nice and tight, there we go. And then these three thin pieces of wood basically acts like a leaf spring to provide downward pressure. And then all you need to do, push it in and it provides quite a bit of downward pressure. And because the hole was angled, it also pulls it in nice and tight against the side of the fence. That's it. I hope you enjoyed it. I hope you learned something. And I hope you can build one for yourself. Thank you very much.